Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video today, we're going to talk about the Last Stand event and how you can complete it in as little as 6 games. In fact, doing this method is so easy, you don't even have to engage with any other players, you don't have to eliminate any other players, and really, when it comes down to it, all you got to do is pop on your favorite movie, music, podcast, and then just jump into a game of Plunder. So for those of you that weren't around when Season 5 dropped yesterday, there's a brand new event in Warzone called Last Stand. This event allows you to play either for the heroes or the villains, giving you points throughout the matches that you play, and once you earn 150,000 points, you'll unlock a brand new weapon blueprint for the MP40. In total, you're going to need 300,000 points for both sides, the heroes and the villains. And when I was playing earlier, I thought to myself, man, this is taking forever. Every kill gives you about 100 points. Picking up the tokens from different loot boxes across the map also give you 100 points. And over the course of a match, you can earn like 2,000 to 3,000 points depending on how much carnage you can create. But if you really wanted to get the points, you're going to want to head into Plunder. Now, I personally feel like this is something that the team at Raven probably plans on patching, because I don't think they intended for you to be able to complete both factions in as little as 6 games. On the high end, you'll be able to earn over 50,000 points per match, and on the more average side of things, you'll probably get between 25 to 40,000. It's really going to depend on how well you're looting, the boxes that you find, the buy stations that you encounter, and of course, the end game. That's the most important part. But really, the plan is go around, loot boxes, pick up money, and then head on over to a buy station and buy faction points. You can buy points for heroes or villains, and every time you spend $10,000, you'll get 500 points. Just like other matches, there's still different contracts that you're able to do. These contracts will award you with a bunch of money. Doing these contracts will also give you a discount at the buy station on specific points for each faction. So if you are playing for either one of the teams and you ended up picking up hero points, for example, you'll be able to get a discount up to half off, and then it will go to 25% off, and then eventually it'll come back to $10,000. But even if you plan on buying the points without the discount, $10,000 is a drop in the bucket in comparison to other game modes. Since money is so abundant here, you can open up one box and get upwards of $38,000 to $58,000, depending on the cash stack that comes out. And now with the supply drop UAVs, you'll be able to find those really valuable ones. The orange boxes will give you a ton of money if you happen to pick those up. But not only that, you'll have cash supply drops that end up falling around the map. You'll also have helicopters you can destroy at the end of the game that will drop a ton of money as well. Really, when it comes down to it, you are going to be constantly collecting money, whether it's from boxes or with your rare encounter with an enemy, depending on where you drop. And I think that's the best part about Plunder. Since we have infinite respawns, even if you're playing solo, you don't have to worry about getting taken out by an enemy. So if you really wanted to, you can go to a hot drop location and try to get as many kills as you possibly can. But just remember, you will definitely be able to find more money by simply looting boxes than actually engaging the enemies, unless you're going for those high value targets or completing contracts. So for the first, I would say 20 minutes of the match, all you want to do is loot. Once your money balance gets around $150,000 to $250,000 that you're holding, you're going to want to find a buy station or a buy station marker, because throughout the match, you will be marked as a high value target and people are going to come for your money. They're going to try to come and get you, and that's the fun in Plunder. But if you're able to find a buy station before the enemies make their way to you and actually deposit it and put it towards the points, then it will take the heat off of you, because you'll no longer be a high value target. You'll no longer be holding all that cash, so you won't be marked on the minimap anymore. Alternatively, you could find buy station markers, which I noticed there are a ton of them in this mode. This is something nice to have in your back pocket, because while you're looting, you won't always be near a buy station. So keeping one of these with you at all times is really nice, especially if there are enemies chasing you and need to escape with one of those redeploy balloons. Drop down your buy station, use up the money in your inventory as quickly as you can to take the heat off of you, and then if you end up dying, it doesn't really matter. I should also mention, if you end up dying while holding a huge stack of cash, you'll lose a little bit of it, but you'll still retain a majority of it. That's pretty much how 90% of your Plunder match is going to go. Looting, completing contracts, taking on a couple of enemies here and there, and of course using the money that you pick up towards the faction of your choice. Then, in the final 10% of a Plunder match, you're gonna go into overtime. Whenever a team hits $1 million deposited, that's when overtime will begin. This is going to allow you to collect more money than you did throughout the entirety of the match, unless you're the team that hit $1 million, of course. But once you start collecting these cash stacks like you've been throughout the entirety of the game, everything's going to be doubled. This gives you ample opportunity to go to a location on the map where enemies may not go, maybe those far off outskirts of buildings and maybe the small villages that people don't really travel to well, maybe visiting the ruins and places like that. Picking up these loot boxes will then give you so much more money. In fact, you're probably going to be earning more money in the final 3 minutes than you did throughout the entirety of the 20-minute match if you're playing solo. This gives you the opportunity to double, if not triple, the amount of points that you're going to get, putting you upwards to 50,000 or more. Now, of course, this is completely dependent on your looting, the location that you end up going to. If enemies had already cleaned it out with all of the different supply boxes, that would suck. But if you're able to find them, you're going to earn a lot of money. And more importantly, if you're completing contracts during this time, the money is also doubled. But you only have a few minutes, so you really have to use your time wisely. At the end of it all, if you have a cash stack of $1 million and you throw down a buy station, you're going to be sitting at that buy station buying your faction points for a minute in itself. So you want to make sure that you also save enough time for you to actually utilize the money that you've picked up in overtime. So yeah, that's pretty much it. There's about 20 days left in this event. So if you were concerned that you weren't going to be able to complete this event because maybe the point balances that you were getting in regular modes wasn't enough, or you weren't able to find enough of those tokens in game, don't worry. This is definitely by far the easiest way to do it. And like I mentioned earlier on in this video, I don't really think the team at Raven intended for you to do it this fast. If they ended up actually coming through and nerfing it in some capacity, the only thing I can really think of them doing is increasing the price of each buy, meaning that you'll only earn a certain amount of points every single game, or by nerfing the points that you get from a buy station altogether, dropping it from 500 down to 250, meaning that it'll take double the time in order to do this, which would still not be too bad because you're going to be getting more points by playing Plunder than even if you were to just play standard Battle Royale or the limited time mode. I guess thinking about it over the course of 20 days, you should be able to get 150,000 points, but 300,000 points is required if you want to complete both sides. And I totally suggest everybody get out there and do this right now, just in case Raven does end up turning around and nerfing this. I'm not saying that they're going to, I'm just saying that it doesn't seem intentional to be able to complete it in little as 6 matches. But anyway, that is everything I wanted to talk about here in this video today. I've actually enjoyed this event quite a bit. Even though I was playing a lot of Plunder, it still gave me something to do, and it really took my attention away from regular Vanguard multiplayer. Anytime my attention gets taken away from Vanguard multiplayer, it's like a breath of fresh air. But that is it. If you guys enjoyed this video here today, do me a favor, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming every single day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. All right, folks, I will catch you on the next one. And good luck with your Plunder adventure. Peace.